Welcome to sunny Southern California, Orange County. What we have here is a couple more of my power boxes. This was the first one, the first big one that I put together. This is the 200 amp hour, and it was about 2.5 kilowatt packs. This one was made up of 50 amp. This one has 16 50 amp prismatic cells, 12 volt setup. And so, my brother in law, who runs a tour guide business at the Grand Canyon, through zombie tours, he is going to start a little B&B with his really nice trailer he has out there. Lead acid battery's not working for him. He's got like four of those 65 pound golf cart batteries, and he's running a 24 volt system. And because of the price and how long they last, these batteries are kind of, I guess he's been using them for about a year and they're already not doing the job. So I put together a 24 volt battery for him. Right over here. This one, I was able to get the 120 amp battery cells, the prismatic and battery hookup. I picked up, this one has 8. So we have an 8S setup, 24 volt Dally BMS, smart BMS. This one came out really nice and clean. This one is not, like, this is completely standalone. It has everything in it, charge controller, inverter. This one is going to hook up in his trailer, which he already has a setup for the 24 volt system. So his, he's got the inverter charger combo thing. It's a 24 volt. And so we're going to be running this. This here comes up to, let's see, we have 24 volts. 120 amps, and it's going to be about a 3 kilowatt, a little over 3 kilowatt pack. I am putting together another one for me that's going to replace the battery in the shed when those die. In the meantime, I put this one in this nice DeWalt box. It has wheels. This one I'm just starting. I did that one first, and my brother-in-law is going to be coming out right after Thanksgiving to pick that up. And I will start putting this together. I just have my 8 battery in here. This one will be 12 volt, just like this one. But I'm not going to have a charge controller, an inverter inside the box. I have another set of those that I keep externally for my smaller packs when I'm camping and all that, and that will work with this one just as well. Plus, this one can hook up straight to, I have a split here in the shed. It can charge directly from this 250 bucks of the panel right there. So let's take a look. This one will have USB, it'll have everything that my other 12 volt does. And here's these 120 amp prismatic cells. They came from battery hookup, they're supposedly grade A. They're all perfectly balanced. And just waiting for me to start snapping things together. I will put plexiglass along these three corners right here just to make sure that these cells are protected on getting bonked. And this is going to leave me plenty of room over here for putting my BMS and all the other
gadgets, USB 3.0 port and a 12 volt port. And then I'll have I got a Victron shunt. I'm gonna be putting on there. I got a Dally 100 amp BMS that'll go in here. And gonna be set. Between these two boxes, I will have 5,000 watts or 5 kilowatts of power. All that can it can be charged from the house during the day if the power's out. My controller on the house is semi off-grid with 35% mode, so I can run 35% of my 5,000 watts on the roof, a little over 5,000. I can use to charge this box, or I can charge it from the shed, either one. So then we'll move over to here. I'm not going to open that one up because it's strapped on, and that was I've already shown that in a previous video. Then this is the new 24 volt. Everything fit in here really nice. Added the little 12 volt light there, works really nice. External hookups here. Oh, move this out of the way. This weighs about, I guess it's 60, 65 pounds. Oh, come on, baby. Let's go over here a little bit. There we go. Okay. We have here is just your regular shunt, not smart or anything, so you turn it on and off right here. Works fine. Got my BMS there. That is a 100 amp 24 volt smart BMS. Get the little Bluetooth dongle. Got the 8 prismatic cells hooked up series, 8S configuration. Here's the shunt. Just using this, what the hell is this tape called? Got 100 amp breaker. West bars. I did like the first one. I made them out of copper, 3/4 inch copper pipe. Trimmed them down, put heat shrink on them. Other than where there's screws involved, everything is soldered and heat shrink. Even all of these I soldered to make sure no wires can come loose. They're crimped and soldered. And then I have my 12 volt buck down converter. So we have our 12 volt DC port over here. And I just put in the voltmeter. It doesn't really matter because this is 12 volt. It's not reading the volts of all the batteries. That's what the shunt's for. And then that's pretty it. Pretty clean little unit. Fits perfectly in this toolbox. And 3 kilowatts of power. Pretty clean setup. So that is it for today's little short video. I will do the same when this one is done. In the meantime, today's weather is about 70 degrees in sunny Southern California. And now I need to clean the pool today. Get ready for Thanksgiving. All right, everybody, have a good week.
Yeah. So this is where we start our tours at. And then we drive these...
You're Buck Willow?
Buck Wild.
Oh, Buck Wild.
Willow.
It looks like a zero.
No, area. It's Buck Wild. Oh. So, yeah. So the people come in and... And there are little offices right inside here.
Oh, cool.